Yes, good morning students. So today we will start our first chapter of maths, that is the fish tank. See, in this chapter we are going to learn, first of all we will see the gist of the chapter, means what all things we are going to learn during this chapter, during the whole chapter. Now first, see, here I have written certain things. These many things we are going to cover in this chapter as per NCERT textbook. Now the first one is height. What is haiku? What is the use of haiku? Where it was originated? These all things we are going to learn in section A. In section B, schools of fish. See, there are many words in English language. They are having two different meanings with the same spelling. So these also we will learn during this chapter. So the C one, third one, simple operations on speed and distance. Now see, most of the topics in this class will be the higher version of your previous class. Means these all topics we have learned in our class 4, but now we will have one step ahead of the 4th class, because now you all are in the 5th class, the senior most class of primary section. Now the simple operations on speed and distance means that in this we are having a many verbal problems or word sounds. That the distance covered by a boat, if the speed of the boat is like that. These many, all these things we will cover during the section C. Now, in section D, simple problems on loans. Corona में सबने सुना ही होगा कि सरकार को loan दे रही है, किसको चाहिए ले लो, ठीक है? तो यहाँ पर भी हम लोग है ना बहुत सारी चीजें पे loans लेते हैं, तो bank हमें loans ऐसे तो कोई देता नहीं, ठीक है ना? तो उसमें इंटरेस्ट कितना चार्ज करती है, हमें एक्स्ट्रा पैसे कितने देने पड़ते हैं, ये सारी चीजें जो है उसका पूरा कैलकुलेशन जो होगी, उसकी बेसिक कैलकुलेशन वो टॉपिक सेक्शन डी में पड़ेगी। द लास्ट वन, लार्ज नंबर्स। आपको अगर याद है जो हमने फोर्थ क्लास में जो हमारा फर्स्ट चैप्टर था, ठीक है, बहुत सारे बच्चे भूल रहे होंगे, व्हाट वाज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ आवर फोर्थ क्लास? इट वॉज द बिल्डिंग विद ब्रिक्स। So in this chapter, in that chapter we have learned about various numbers like ones, tens, hundred, thousand, ten thousand and lakh. Up to 1 lakh we have learned in our 4th class. But in 5th class, we will learn up to and beyond 1 lakh, that is 10 lakh and 1 crore. We will go 2 steps ahead of our previous class. So in this large numbers, we will mainly discuss about the writing that numbers in number names, writing that numbers in number in words, these all things, place values, place, greater than, lesser than or smaller than, is equal to, ascending order, descending order, these all basic concepts we will clear in this large numbers. Now, we will have, in today's lecture, we will continue, we will start with the first topic, that is height. What is a haiku? See, here you can see a special poem in 3 lines is called a haiku. See, any poem, see, there are many types of poem. Any special poem which contains or which consists of only 3 lines is called haiku. Yani short mein hum log keh sakte hain ki jo 3 line ki jo poem hai, usko hum haiku kehte hain. Dekho, ab ye jo hai haiku hai wo literature ka type. Maths mein to nahi aata, theek hai na? लेकिन यहां कभी आपको ऐसा नहीं पूछा जाएगा कि आप एक एग्जाम में कभी ऐसा नहीं पूछा जाएगा कि एक हाइकु लिखो आप, ठीक है? तो ये सब हमें याद करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस इसको समझना जरूरी है, क्योंकि टेक्स्ट बुक में दिया हुआ है, तो इसको हम अच्छे से समझेंगे कि हाइकु क्या होता है, ठीक है ना? तो ये जो है स्पेशल पोएम है, तो सिर्फ 3 लाइन की होती है, बहुत शॉर्ट पोएम होती है। सच पोएम्स अबाउट नेचर आर पॉपुलर इन जापान। ऐसी पोएम्स जापान में बहुत पॉपुलर है, ठीक है ना? अबाउट नेचर मतलब जो है कुदरत में हमने जो जो संसाधन दिए हैं उसके बारे में ये पोएम है। हवा, पानी है, ठीक है, पहाड़ है, जमीन है, ठीक है, जो जानवर रहते हैं, ठीक है, उसके बारे में सारी पोएम्स बनी रहती है, ठीक है ना? तो वो जापान में बहुत पॉपुलर है। नाउ विल सी सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ हाइकु। सी, नाउ आई रीड इट आउट फॉर यू। डीप अंडर द सी, सी द लवली कलर्ड फिश स्विमिंग पीसफुली। ठीक है, we can see only we are having the 3 lines, 1, 2, and 3. So this is a small poem containing 3 lines is called haiku. इसको याद करने की जरूरत नहीं है, बस समझने की जरूरत है कि जब भी 3 लाइन की पोएम होती है उसको हम हाइकू कहते हैं। लेट अस हैव अ सेकंड एग्जांपल फॉर हाइकू। द लेक,
calm, smooth, still. A fish jumps up and returns. Ripples shake the lake. See, here also we can see the three lines. It is content. See, both these poems are totally attached with the nature. Means it is describing the nature, how that the fish is living under the water. These all things are telling about the height. Now, your homework is, in today's class, we'll finish it here. Your homework is, do you know any poem on fish? If you know the poem, then you can comment or write it down in the comment box. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.